gods to be rather than all flesh. Your sons and your daughters shall prophesy. Your young men shall see visions. The old men shall dream dreams. Jesus himself spoke about that power. But he shall receive power after the Holy Ghost has come upon you. And he shall be witnesses unto my people in Jerusalem, and in all Judea, and in Samaria, and unto the uttermost part of the earth. When the day of Pentecost was fully come, the disciples of Christ prayed with great expectation, awaiting the coming promise of power. Suddenly there came a sound from heaven, as of a rushing, mighty wind, and it filled the house where they were sitting. And they were all filled with the Holy Ghost, and began to speak with other tongues, as the Spirit gave them utterance. The people that day marveled, and asked, "What does this mean?" Then Peter lifted up his voice and declared, "This is that. That which was spoken by the prophet Joel. These were the first of the last days. This is that Jesus promised would empower his chosen disciples to go into all the world and preach the gospel." That same experience has swept through the centuries. Nearly 1900 years later, preachers began boldly proclaiming tongues as the initial evidence of the baptism of the Holy Spirit. Thousands sojourned the breaks of Azusa Street to witness the miracles, signs, and wonders. That Pentecostal phenomenon was felt here on the streets of Indianapolis as men like G.T. Hayward began proclaiming the promise of spirit baptism. It was an awakening. The church has survived the onslaught of history. What once was experienced in an upper room, tent revival meetings, convention halls, and basketball arenas has now moved into a new realm.
We should be in football stadiums, not basketball courts.
This is the youth conference is a sign that miracles and wonders are here.
Not sure when.